Okay, folks, we're almost done with the section, final lesson. It's an important lesson because we're going to just run through a few things, make sure that our user experience is as intended. And I usually always find little niggles, little issues that I need to solve. We've got a few to solve now, but we also have to think about deleting an application. Because remember, in step one in the previous lesson, an application is created and then a file is attached to that application. So there might be the case that a user starts an application, creates something in the database, and then changes their mind, and we've got the cancel button to deal with that. So let's also make sure that we close off that final issue before we round out this section. Let's dive in. Okay, so I'm still logged in as Peter, and I have opened up the job page, and I've opened up pop-up application, and please do the same. And we know that if we click on next, we are setting the state to 2, but we are also creating an application. And herein lies the potential issue, in that we might have people clicking next to upload their CV and then change their mind. And we don't want all of these partial applications in the database. Hey, maybe you would like them for analytic purposes to better your UX. But in this instance, I'd like to just demonstrate how to delete an application and delete a file, okay? Because there's something interesting I'm about to demonstrate when it comes to how Bubble handles files and images. So before we actually create the workflow for canceling, let's first talk about files. I'd like you to preview the page. And let's go back to browse jobs, make sure that you can see Peter's image, which proves that you are logged in. I'm going to choose the first one, product developer. Okay, now we've got page data, fantastic. Now click on the apply button. Let's go ahead and write a cover note. And I'm going to click next. Okay, now let's actually jump into the database and see where we're at. Heading over to the data tab, app data, and applications, and you can see that here is a new application, but it does not have a CV. Okay, click on cancel. Now I want you to go across to file manager, please. File manager. Look at all of these CVs that have been uploaded. Here's the file name. And we have got attached to, and this is the unique ID of an application. Today for me is April 15th. So I would like you to go back to the front end and let's attach a CV, but we are not going to click on submit application. Just go ahead, find Peter's CV again. Okay. So we've used the element to upload the CV. Let's go back to the database. Now I'm just going to refresh this page. And you can see it's April 15th and that we've just populated the file manager with Peter Hudson's new CV. And it says attached to. So I'm going to copy this unique ID. Head back to app data, going to click on applications, and I'm going to paste this unique ID into the search. And there we go. So basically, we know that if I go to file manager, as a developer, I can see all uploaded files and they don't need to be saved to a field. So this is how Bubble handles image and file uploads. When a picture uploader, when this value is populated, meaning a person has uploaded an image, or a file uploader, when this value has been populated, meaning someone has uploaded a file like I've just demonstrated, well, it is then saved to the server. But when it comes to our field in the application, we have a field called CV of type file. Bubble only saves the link. Okay. So the file is hosted elsewhere. It's hosted but it's not in that particular field. That is only the link. Meaning that when we do delete an application, we're not actually deleting the CV, we're only deleting the link to the CV. So if we delete an application without deleting the hosted file, that hosted file, CV, becomes orphaned. But we can still find it in our file manager, but as a busy developer with a scaling app, it's not something we want to manage ourselves. Okay, so we need to build a workflow that first deletes this hosted CV, then we'll delete the entire application. Okay. Let's go back to the front end. And yeah, let's just submit this application. Okay, we've still got the problem of we didn't see a confirmation message. Let's go back to the database. And now in the database under applications, the link to that CV is now saved to this field and I can see this CV. There it is there. Now, before we go any further, I'd like you to do the following. Now, we've talked about file privacy. We have attached the file and we can see it in File Manager. We've attached it to an application. So what would happen if a user that isn't authorized to view this file, what would happen if they tried to view the link? First of all, let's go grab the link. So app data. And I'm going to click on C again. Okay, so you can see that we have something called access key up here. It expires, it's got a signature, all this cryptographic information. The actual link would be up until the parameters start. So this is the link here. So HTTPS all the way to the name of this PDF file. I'm going to copy this link. Then I'm just going to close this tab. Now I'd like you to go to the Scratchpad page, please, because we need to log out of Peter. We've saved this URL link and we're going to log out of Peter's account as if we're just a regular user in possession of this link. It's been shared through an email or some other means. Let's see if we can access it. So I'm going to just add Scratchpad to the URL. I'm going to log out. And in the same tab, I'm going to paste the URL. And we can see access has been denied. Okay, so this proves that you need to be logged in as Peter into a workplace. You need to be logged in as Peter or Hannah for that URL to work, the URL to be able to view the CV and therefore download the CV. If you don't meet those conditions, you get this access is denied. Okay. Okay, I'm going to log back in as Peter. I'll do it through the database run as. Just need to make sure that you remove anything from the search, otherwise results won't show. And I'm going to run as Peter. I'm going to go to browse jobs. And then back to the product developer, the bubble job. And just get this ready for the next stage. All right, let's now talk about canceling an application, which on our end actually means deleting a file and deleting an application. So I'm going to go to the design tab, bring up the pop-up application. And while we're here, let's just quickly add the confirmation workflow step. If we edit workflow on the next button and under step two, I'd just like you to add a new step 5, which simply says show message. So after a successful application has been made, we close the pop-up and show the success message. Fine. Now for the interesting one, let's look at this cancel button. When add a workflow, Okay, so what we're going to do is go down to Data and Things and delete an uploaded file. Now remember, we determined that a file is uploaded once the file uploader element is populated, which means we can actually just point to the file uploader to then delete an uploaded file. So I'm going to say file uploader attach your CVs value. Okay, so that takes care of that. Now in terms of deleting the application itself, we can choose data and things and simply delete thing. Where is the thing? Well, after step one, or at step one, we create an application and then set a state. Okay, so we can simply point to the state. So that is a pop-up applications application. Okay, application being the state. After that, what we can do is hide the pop-up. And then what I'm also going to do is just refresh the page. It's just a habit of mine. Sometimes we need to reset data, reset element inputs as well. And I prefer just to refresh the page because it does all of it. Okay, just resets the page back to its default. And it's pretty quick as well. Okay, so now we need to run through this process to prove that an uploaded file will be deleted and an application will be deleted, and we're not getting an orphaned uploaded file, and we'll be referencing the file manager for that purpose. Back to the front end. Okay, so I'm at /job/product/developer. Now let's go ahead and apply. This is my cover note. Click on next. Okay, so that's now created the application in the database. Let's confirm. Head over to data, applications, and yes, here it is here. I've just created it and there's no CV uploaded. So now if we cancel this, we're not going to upload a CV just yet. Let's cancel it. Page is refreshed, back to the database, back down to two applications. Let's go a bit further now. Go back to apply. This is my cover note. Click next. Now I'm going to upload a CV, but I'm not going to upload Peter Hudson's. I'm going to upload someone else's, just so it's clear to see in the file manager. I'm going to open up the file manager. And we can see we've only got Peter Hudson's CVs here. I'm going to attach a CV, and I'm using Raymond Williams' CV this time. Okay, Raymond Williams. I'm going to refresh the page here. Here it is here. Okay, so we're at the stage where it's attached to the applications. From a privacy standpoint, not in the actual application itself, because that's in the next step where we save the link. You see the CV field is still empty because we haven't saved the link. But in File Manager, we've made the association through the privacy to attach it to that actual application. Back to the front end. Now I'm going to cancel. So I'm hoping that in File Manager and in the database, both the CV is deleted from File Manager and the application is deleted from the database. Let's go ahead and cancel. Page refreshes, back to the default. Moment of truth. I'm going to refresh the page. And as you can see, Raymond Williams' CV has been deleted and in the database. We're now down to two applications, one, two. Okay, so that takes care of that. So I hopefully that was a good explanation of how Bubble handles files and images. A lot of the time you'll be attaching files and images just to the current user. For instance, if they're uploading some sensitive data about themselves for identification purposes or banking related stuff, that'll always be attached to the current user unless more than one entity or more than one party needs access. And that's part of the reason why we have an application data type. So we can separate out our data type and then have two entities access that information, okay? All right, guys, I just wanted to apply for two new jobs and then we will finish off this lesson. So I'm going to apply for this one more time. This is my cover note, so I'm going to upload my regular CV here. And I'm going to apply for one more. Go ahead, anyone will do. I just wanted to populate the database with a bit more stuff. I'm going to choose Brainwave Community Manager. And let's go back to the candidate dashboard. Click on applications. Yeah, and here are our applications. Okay, guys, that's it for this section. Hope you enjoyed it. Definitely pushed the functionality part a little bit more. I hope you can see how things are starting to sort of gel and come together. In the next section, we're going to be dealing back with Hannah and her company dashboard, because now she has applications coming through. We're going to sign up two new users, Eric and Raymond. They're going to be making applications. We're going to look at privacy rules again. That's going to be super, super fun. I just have one ask, and I'm going to ask for this once, okay? And that is, if you haven't subscribed to our Bubble YouTube channel, please go ahead and do so. It really, really does help bring the channel to more people that are eager to learn, just like yourself. It doesn't cost you anything, and it's not like me to ask for these things, so I won't mention it again. But I hope you're enjoying it so far, and I'll see you in the next section.